Hey everyone, it's Chris from Recombu, and I'm here to play a bit of Spot the Difference. We've got the iPhone 6S and the iPhone 7. We're going to put them side by side and see what actually is the difference. Now, first glance, you might think I've got two of the same phone here. They really do look very, very similar. But actually, there is a lot of difference between these two handsets, more than some people are given credit for, to be honest. So let's have a quick flick around in terms of design. As you can see, we've got the gold model of the iPhone 7 and the silver model of the iPhone 6S. And in terms of general design, as you can see, they look very, very similar indeed. One immediate obvious difference is, of course, the fact we've got a headphone jack on the 6S and we have not got a headphone jack on the iPhone 7, which means that you can either use headphones which plug into the Lightning port or wireless headphones. Either is good. You do get that extra speaker, which, to be honest, doesn't make a massive amount of difference. The top works as a speaker as well, so you get this nice sort of stereo speaker output. But, you know, it's a phone speaker. It's about as good as a phone speaker ever gets. So we definitely recommend connecting headphones, a Bluetooth speaker, something like that, if you really want to pump out some tunes. One difference that you can't see is the fact that this is now water resistant. The iPhone 7 can take a good old dunking in the bath. Or in the shower, the toilet, if you're a bit tipsy, which has happened to me a couple of times. Whoops. So that's good, and that will survive quite happily as long as you obviously don't crack the screen or anything. iPhone 6S, not so much. It's splash resistant at best, really, to be honest. You can sort of see that Apple had started to put some water-resistant qualities in it. It's not quite as susceptible to water damage as previous models, but again, do not give it a Dunkin'. One other difference is that the iPhone 7 now comes in a glossy jet black model, which apparently is quite susceptible to scratches, but also looks the business. So that's worth trying out if you're a bit bored of the old metallic design. This is, of course, the metallic gold model, which I still think looks quite nice. As you can see, they've removed the aerial bands as well from the 6S just to clean up the look of it a bit, which is quite nice. So yeah, apart from that, you also get the new Force Touch Home button, which isn't massively different from the old one. Basically, the idea is that it provides, you get better haptic feedback and everything, apparently. So instead of actually clicking all the way in, like the old iPhone 6S's does, it actually just gives you a little bit of vibration action when you tap it. And you can, of course, set all that up as well. If you go into General and then Home button, you can select exactly what kind of click you want. It's from a modest little vibration all the way up to a proper full-on bit of feedback. The entire phone does tend to vibrate a little bit with it, but it's you know, it's nothing. It's not really an issue. Let's put it. You're not going to buy an iPhone 7 over an iPhone 6S or vice versa because of the Home button. So let's not dwell on it, eh? There's no 16GB model anymore, the iPhone 7. It starts at 32GB and goes up to 256GB. Whereas the iPhone 6S, the base model, is 16GB. So you tend to run out of storage really fast on that. So it's good that Apple has finally ditched the crappy 16GB model. Of course, neither have got expandable storage. You just got the SIM card slot and that's it. There's no support for micro SD, which is a bit of a bummer, but never mind. In terms of the screens themselves, there's not much difference there. If we just boost up the brightness here, the brightness is supposed to be slightly better on the iPhone 7. To be honest, I haven't really noticed that much of a difference, maybe ever so slightly brighter in some conditions, but you do get that wider color gamut now, which means slightly more realistic images. But again, side by side, you sort of struggle to notice much of a difference, you know, in terms of image quality. The photos and videos look absolutely stunning on both the 6S and the 7. You're not going to struggle there. Yeah, movies, photos, all the rest of it look absolutely fantastic. So no problem at all. In terms of performance, you get the new A10 Fusion processor stuffed inside this bad boy, which is super nippy. Haven't seen a single stutter or anything. And to be honest though, the A9 processor in the iPhone 6S is still holding up very, very well. It might not be quite as good in the benchmark and all the rest of it, but as you can see, apps load up the second you hit them, and there's generally very little delay waiting for it to all kick in and everything. So yeah, definitely in terms of performance, we have no complaints on either front. You get a slightly bigger battery in the iPhone 7, as we have noticed the battery life is slightly better. Tend to get close to a day and a half with sort of reasonably restrained use on the iPhone 7, whereas you'd be lucky if you make it much over 24 hours with the iPhone 6S. So definitely better battery life. In terms of charging and everything, it's exactly the same. So it'll still take you between an hour and a half for a full charge. And then final difference is the camera tech. So if we flick up to the cameras, Again, you'll struggle to notice any real difference. Let's just get the bow tie bear up. And in terms of the actual app itself, as you can see, there's not really any difference there. It's still the same old app that we know and love. You once again get live photos and all the rest of it in iPhone 7, which you get in the iPhone 6s as well. But you might notice that the iPhone 7's image is ever so slightly brighter. That's because it's got a wider aperture lens now, which really helps to suck in more light and produce those sort of brighter, more detailed photos. In daytime, you don't notice much difference, but certainly at night it does make a difference, as does the built-in optical image stabilization, which was missing from the iPhone 6s, which means that you do tend to get sort of nicely more detailed, less blurry and grainy shots at night, which is definitely good. Once again, focus is super fast and you can manually focus and fiddle around with the brightness manually as well. And as you can see, you get all the usual video modes, slow-mo mode, time-lapse mode, all the rest of it as well. So no real changes there. In terms of the actual settings and everything, it's all basically the same camera that we know and love. The front-facing camera has been improved as well. You now get a 7-megapixel front-facing camera. So if we flick to that, there's me in all my glory. And of course, all the usual HDR and everything built in as well. So you get a bit more detail packed into your selfie shots. And that, in a nutshell, is the iPhone 7 versus the iPhone 6S. Both very good phones. You can, of course, pick up the 6S a little bit cheaper these days, now that the 7 is out. But of course, it does start in that base 16 gig model. So you might have to bump up the cost a bit to get a bit more storage. So that's the two of them side by side. Let us know what you think in the comments, and which one would you buy? Thank you.